Have you remember? I have completed. If you have any doubt, so please, you can ask. So these are the way by which we can change the permissions by using this particular. So these are two ways, and chmod is a command to change the permissions. We can change permission by using chmod command. By using the symbolic mode. So these are the way to apply the permissions. Create a directory, and we can change. If we want to apply, we can use plus sign for O for other, A for all, U for user, that I have discussed earlier. So we can apply read permission, write permission, execute permissions. If we want to add, use plus sign. If we want to remove, use minus sign. If you set the exact permission, it means you want to override the old permission, so you can use the equal sign. So this is the sign you can use. You can apply permission on user, group, and others. If you want to change the permission for all, you can use A option. So these are the things that I have told you earlier. So these are the numerical. By using the numerical mode, we can use these things. We want to apply read permission, use 4. Write permission, use 2. Execute, use 1. So we can apply these numerical numbers. If you want to apply no permission, so you can use 0. If you remove the permission, if you apply no permission, just like that, you can apply 755, you can apply 777, you can apply 444, you can apply 750. So this means user, this means group, this means others. So user, group, and others, you can apply the permissions. So these are all discussed in earlier classes. Now my today's session is this: changing the file and directories, user and group ownership. So I will discuss today about these, all of these things. So as you know that when we create any particular file, every particular file has a user owner, and every particular file has a group owner, as you know that, just like this.
No.
Suppose if you want to create a file, which command you will use to create any file? Which command you will use to create a blank file? Which command? You know about the command to create any file?
No.
As I have discussed with you, touch is a command to create a blank file, to create a blank file, to create an empty file, just to create touch. Suppose this is the name of the file, and I want to assign the extension solo. So we can assign the extension. So this is the extension. So this is my file name. Suppose when you create any file, this file will have a user owner also, and this file will also have the group owner also. So which command is used to display the user owner and group owner? We can use ls command. Hyphen l means list. We want to list a file, we don't use d. For the directory we can use d, for files only l. Then the name of the file. So this is name, this is my user owner, and this is my group owner. So every file you create in your system, it will use a user owner and group owners. So this user create this particular file, so I can recognize which user create this file. Suppose we create a user, the username is joint. Then this user create a file same way. We create this particular file. Now you can check what is the user ownership of this, because this user create this file, so this is the user owner. Now I want to change this user ownership. I want to change this user owner. I want to change this group owner. So this is my topic, today topic. So I change user and group ownership. So this is my topic, how to changing file and directory, user and group ownership. So we can use this. So changing file and directory, user ownership. So when you create any file in the system, who create that file? By default, new files has a group ownership, that is a primary group. So this group is a primary group. When we create any user, this user create the user account also create, and the same way, same name, a primary group create also. So this is the way when we create any file, this have a user owner also, this has a group owner cell also, and I want to change this particular user owner and group owner. So how I can change this? So we can use ch own command and ch grp command. So I will discuss about ch, what is ch own command and what is ch grp commands. So these are my topic. So we can use only root. Who can change the user ownership of any file folders? Only root can change the user ownership and group ownership. File ownership can be changed by this particular command. This is a command. Command means change owner. And we want to change the ownership recursively. So we can use R option. So when we create any directory, any file, so every particular file, every particular directory has its own user that is created by the users who perform the command. So I will change the user owner. I will change the group owner also. So now we log out from this user. We create a directory. The directory name is new data sales. This is my folder. And I have created this folder. And I want to change what is the owner of this particular directory. What is the group owner of this particular directory? So root created. So it will automatically obtain the user ownership and group ownership of root. Like this. / new data sales. So this is the user owner. And this is the group owner. I want to change.
Okay, you lost Stare. You lost Stare. I'll find a way to translate it. I'll find a way to translate it. People will always say
you
need
something else. Like, you want to change the ownership. So what I will do?
That's bad manners.
So we use ch own command. Okay. So. And we create a new user. We have a user, ch own. Username is this. This is my user. And I want to provide the ownership of this particular user. So then, and we also provide the group ownership at the same time. So what I will use to separate this, use colon. And this is my group. And I want to change the group at the same time. we have a group. Okay, at this time we only change the user owner, and this is my directory name. This is my directory name. So now we can check. Now your user ownership will be changed. So this is the owner, and this has the this permission. This owner has what permission? At this time, this user has read, write, execute permission. And we want to change this group owner. So I check I have any group or not. We have a group. The group name is, we have a sales or not. I want to check. This is my group. Suppose we have two user in this group. These are two user in this group. The group name is Windows. And I want to assign this group ownership. So what I will do? So this is the command. And I want to change this Windows. D-O-W-S. And the command will be changed. GRP. This is the command to change the group ownership. This is my command, CHGRP. And this is my group name. And this is my directory name. So we can change the group owner also. So now you can check. This is the user owner and this is my group owner. So now we have read, write, execute permission on this particular users, and this particular has also two user that I have. This user, this group has two user. Now we can check grep Windows. Now these two user have the group ownership. So these have read execute permission. And for others, it has this permission. Suppose we change permission. For change permission, we can use chmod command 770. Now we can check this 7 means full permission for this particular user. And this 7 means full permission for this particular group. And for others, there is no permission. So now we have full permission for the user owner, full permission for the group owner, and no permission for the others. Now give the directory name. So now you can check. I will demonstrate you this. I will check this is right or wrong. So now we can check this. So at this time we have full permission on this particular user and full permission on this particular user accounts on from the on the group. And this group has two user. These two user has full permission. Now check this. How I can check this? Then log in to the user. The username is ACTUser02. This is my username. And I want to check this. So CD, I want to move this particular directory. This particular directory. Now we have full access on this. Then create directory also. So now you can check. We create directory in this location, but any other user want to create directory and other types of work, he can't do because others user have no permission. Suppose we have another user. The username is Anas. We have another user. The another username is Anas. And this user want to access this particular directory. This particular directory. So check, it has no permission because this is a other user. This is a other user. So it has no permission because we assign no permission on other user. Only this user owner and only this group owner have full rights, not for others. Suppose we have a department, account, sales, marketing, others. We want the sales department only have the permission and not for the other department. So like this, we can assign the permissions. This is a sales department. This is a account department. So only to the group that belong to that departments, we can assign full permission. And for others, we can also assign the read permission, read execute permission, and no permission also that I want to assign. So there, at this time, this user has no permission. Only ACT user 1, ACT user 2, and this particular user have the access on this particular directory. So only this user and then this group users also have the permission. Have you any doubt about this? Then I will clear by using another example. If you have any doubt. Hello.
Yes, hello.
You have any doubt?
Not fine.
Okay. So now we will move to another concept. So as I have told you, this command is used to change the group ownership, and this command is used to change the user ownership. Suppose we won't use only this particular command. We want to use only this particular command to change the user owner and group owner both. So it can change. It only used to change the group owner. It can perform both tasks, user owner also and group owner also, like this. Suppose we want to change CHO and we change the ANAS, A-N-A-S, ANAS. I want to change the user owner. At this time, this is my user owner and I want to change this. And at the same time, I want to change the group owner also. So we can change. Suppose my group name is Linux. So this is my group name. After the colon, we assign group. Only group we can use also by after the colon. Before the colon, it's a user owner. After the colon, it's a group owner. So at the same time, we can change. So now we want to check. So now at this time, ANAS has the full access at this time. Now, as I have login, want to change the directory. At this time, this has no permission. Now, I want to check this again. So you can check. It has the permission because we changed the owner. So this owner has this permission. Okay. So like this, we can change the user ownership. We can change the user ownership, group ownership. So these are the commands. Then we will move to another topic. So like this, we can change. So these are concepts to change the owner. We can give the owner name. It would change the group, then give the group owner name. So we can use chown command. We can use chgrp command for different purpose. To change the user owner group owners like this particular way. And we can change. We have a directory. The directory name is new data. And we want to change if we have another file and directory in this particular folder. So these also have the group ownership of this particular. So we can use hyphen r option for recursively. Folders and subfolders also have the group ownership same. So we can use this like this particular way. And we can also use dot option. We can also use dot in the place of colon. It also work like this. Suppose we want to change this again. And we want to change. Suppose we want to change this. This is my name. And we want to change this sales. No. Not this. We want to use only dot decimal and give the group name. Group name is Windows. So like this way we also change. So this is my user owner, this is my group owner. So like this way we also change. So these are the changing the user owner group owners. Now we will discuss about special permission. This is my next topic. Have you any doubt? Okay. So we will move to this particular. Special, what is a special permission? This is a fourth level of permissions. Earlier we discussed only three level. Three level means user, owner and others. Now we want to assign a special permission. Just like we can assign SUID. It means super user identification. So this is the special permission, and we want to assign the SGID, super group identification, and we want to assign sticky bit. So these are the special permission. These are used to assign special effect. Like we discuss first sticky bit. Suppose we have a file, so there is no effect on file. When we apply a sticky bit, there is no effect on file. But if we want to apply a sticky bit on a folder, so what is the effect of this particular permission? User with right access to the directory. If any user have the right access on any directory, can only remove the file. Suppose we have a directory and any user, any group have the access permission, can remove the file. That is the owner. Owner only can remove the file, not for the other. If we create a file, my name is user one. Only user one can remove the file, not the other users. So what I will do? We can apply sticky bit. Cannot remove or force save to files owned by other user. If any other user not have the ownership, he can't delete the file. So for this, we can apply this particular special permission. Like I will demonstrate you by using one example. Suppose we have a directory. Directory name is, we create a environment for this. Suppose we have a user. Username is new user 01. We have a user and user 01. Okay, we have a another user this, and we have a group. My group name is and group 01. This is my group name. So these are the commands. Okay. I have typed this wrong. Group. This is the command. And group. This is my group 00. This is my group name. So now we can check this /etc/passwd. And I want to check. So type here head, sorry, tail. What is the use of this command? This will show my only two user. My username is not two, we type three. So we have two user, and user one and user two. Okay, and we have a group also. This is my group name. At this time, there is no user in this group. So how I will add a user in this group? Please tell me the command, because I have told you this earlier classes, how I can add a user, in group. So what is the command? Please tell me. Have you remember or not? I want to add a user in group. Which command we will use? Hello.
Yes, hello.
Okay. I want to add a user in a group. Which command we will use? Have you remember or not? Because in earlier class I have told you. Have you remember?
No.
Which command we will use? This is my question. Add a user in a group. So which command we will use to add a user in a group? Okay, so this is the command. This is the command to modify any user. And I want to add a user in this group. This is my group name. Then type option G. Then give the name of the group. This is my group name. And this is my username. This is my username. Okay, so now you can check. Now we can check the user will be added. This one user added, and I want to add another user also. The another username is 02 and user 02. So these two user will be added in this group. So now we can check. So have you remembered this particular command that I have told you earlier? So this command to add a user in a group. So we create a scenario for which we want to perform a practical, that is SU, that is a sticky bit. So for sticky bit, we create a scenario. So at this time we have a user. Username is and user 01 and user 02, and these are in a group, and we want to assign a permission, full permission on this group. So these two users can access any file and directory. So we create a new file. The new file is and user data. And user data. At this time, you can check what is the user ownership and what is the group ownership of this particular directory and user data. So check. This is my owner and this is my group owner. And I want to change only the group owner. What is my group? This is my group. I want to change only this. So use ch own command colon. Give the name of the group. This is my group name. And on which directory you want to apply this? And this is my directory name. So now you can check. Your group owner will be changed. at this time this group owner have this permission and I want to change this. For changing we use ch mode command 770. We apply 770. So then first 7 means it's for this and second 7 means it's for this, and for others we are assigned no permission. On which directory? This is my directory name. So now you can check again, this is the permission. Suppose the users belong to this particular group want to access this particular directory and he creates files and folders. So now I will check these are the permission or not. SU hyphen N user 01. So now login from this user SU hyphen N user 02. Login from this user. So now at this time, go to directory and user data. This is my directory name. And I am creating a file. Not like this. SU. Okay. Now I will check this. Now check, this is my user 01 and I want to go this particular directory and user data. At this time we are in this particular directory and create one file. File name is this. The file name is this underscore file one. Okay, and I also create another file through this user. Go to the directory user data and create another file. This. So now check, this file is created by this particular user and this file is created by this particular user. Suppose at this time this user in this particular directory and this user also in this particular directory, both have full rights. Suppose for any reason, if we want to delete a directory, suppose this user delete this user directory. So he can remove or not. So give the name of this particular directory. So now you can check. This user can delete the directory of another user. So this is not a good permission. This is not a good management. If any user delete the directory or files of other user, it's not a good way. So who for this we can use as sticky bit. Sticky bit allow only the owner. This owner can delete this particular file and this owner can delete this particular file. So this can be possible by assigning a sticky bit. If we want the user which create the file can only remove the file or directory, not the other user. Suppose this is the owner and this is the owner. Only this this create this file, only remove this user. So it can be possible by using the sticky bit. So now, what is the means of sticky bit? Users with write access to the directory can only remove the files they own. If the only the owner can delete the file, not the other, when we apply this permission. At this time, any user can delete the other user's file also. Suppose this is a user one, and this delete the file of other users. This will come and show where is my file. It found this user not found its own file. So it remove the another user file. So it's not a good way. If any user can delete the other user file, it's a vulnerability in a network environments. So to remove this particular types of activities, so we can use sticky bit. So sticky bit is used to remove this type of activity. Like we use chmod command, then sticky bit also only you applied on the other, then use plus sign, then T symbol. T is used for the sticky bit. When we apply a sticky bit on this particular directory, the directory name is n user data. So now you can check sticky bit is applied or not. How I can check this? So this is the sign. Color is blue, and this is the sign. When we have T in a capital, it means it has no execute permission. When it is in small T, it means it has a execute sign, because in this place we used X. If it has X, it's in a small letter. If it's not have X execute permission, it's in a capital letter. So this is the sticky bit. Now we create the file in the same way. This user create a file also, and this user again create a file. And for this we can check this file is created by this particular user, and this file is created by this particular user. Only this particular user can remove this file, not by this particular user. Suppose this is user 2. So this is the file of user 2. And I want to remove the file of user 1. This is the file of user 1. And I want to remove this -rvf. I want to remove. Can I remove or not? So I will show you. So at this time, what it will show? Operation not permitted, because we have applied a sticky bit at this time. So when you apply a sticky bit, only the owner can delete the file, not the other user. If the other user have the full permission also, this user also have the full permission on this particular directory, but not allowed to remove the file of other user. This is user 2. It can only remove this particular file, not this file. So this can be possible by using the sticky bit. So have you any doubt in sticky bit? So this is the theory that I demonstrate to you. Hello, any doubt regarding sticky bit? Then I will clear. Show you. Have you any doubt regarding this?
Clear. It's clear. Clear.
Okay. Okay. So now I will discuss this particular topic. Suppose at this time, this user, all users create its own file, but at this time you see it's a owner of this particular user, ownership of this particular users, and I want to assign because of this for the other reasons, like this user belong to sales and this user also belong to sales. I want when any user create file folders, the group ownership will be the sales, automatically will be the sales. So what I will do, only ownership, by using the ownership we can recognize which user create this file, and I want the group ownership also. This belong to sales department, so in the place of this will be sales. Then this is a account department, the in the place of the username, in the place of this, so they just account. So I want the group ownership will be same for all the group users. So these belong to which particular group? These belong to this particular group. I want only this. Suppose just like it's a account, it's just like a marketing, it's just like a sales. So any user belongs to any department, the group ownership will be same at all time when the user create a file or folders. So we can assign group ownership. So this is the group ownership. Group ownership means super group identification. When it will applied on a file, what is the effect on the file? File execute the groups as the groups, execute by the group ownership that owns the file. When we apply this on a directory, what is the effect? Group ownership set to that match the group ownership. When it will match the group ownership, so it will automatically apply on the directory. So this is the effect of this particular, just like that. I will show you one example. So we want to change the group ownership. What I will do? We want to change the group ownership. So we can use chgrp command. Yeah, or we can use chown command. We can use both. Hyphen r means recursively. In this directory, we have other files, folders, and I want to change the group ownership at the same time of these particular subdirectories, files. So use which this. So at this time, now check. This is my group owner and I want to change this. So which option we will use? This option we will use. So now you can check all the files and directories ownership will be changed. So this command is used to change the group ownership of directory and its subdirectory and files also. So in this directory we have two files, the group ownership will be changed. So by which we can recognize this belong to the sales department, account department, marketing department, Windows department, sales team, etc. But it's not a permanent solution. When we create another file, so now you can check the group ownership is the same as the user. It's not a permanent solution. When this user also create another file, the group ownership will be user 01. It's not a permanent solution. I want the permanent solution. When any user create file in this particular directory, the group ownership will be this, not this. Any user, for any user. So what I will do? I can apply SGID bit. What I will do? I can apply SGID bit. It means we can apply SGID bit. this is a special permission, super group identification. So how I will apply this? Use chmod command, and it will be applied on a group. Then give this and add a plus sign. Then I want to apply this particular symbol. S for SGID bit, and S is also used for SUID bit. And we want to apply this sticky bit, SGID bit, on which particular directory? This is my directory name, on which I want to apply this. So you can check. So this is the sticky bit. This is the fourth level permission. In this, I have also a execute permission. When S is small, it means it has execute. When S is capital, in a capital letter, it means it not has the execute permission. When S is a small, means have the execute also. S is in a capital, means it not have execute permission. So now you can check. I will create another file. File 3, I will create, and this all user also have created another file 3. Now you can check what is the group ownership of this particular file. This will automatically take the group ownership and check this particular file. Same. When we create any file, any directory in this particular directory, because this particular directory has the group ownership of this, so we'll also take the group ownership of this particular directory, not individual. At the earlier, it take the individual users. When this user create, this will also get the primary group ownership, group ownership of the same user. At this time, we have the group ownership. This user create this file, but at this time, it has the group ownership of what? We create, this user create this file at this time. So now this, you can check. It take the group ownership, will be same. So when we use this particular command, the effect of this particular command, the group ownership will be same as the directory, as the parent directory. We can say that parent directory. When we create subdirectory files, will take the group ownership will be same. So for this, we can use sticky bit. Suppose we have a question for you. So please tell me the answer of this particular question. Hello. 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 Hello.
Yes, hello.
Oh, okay. Read this. Read this first. Then I will. Suppose
group
this question say me create this directory. The directory name is shared. Under this shared, we have another directory, sysadmin. This is the question that come in exam of Red Hat. These are the questions that come in the exam. Suppose change the group ownership. that I have discussed you. The group ownership will be this. This is my group name, sysadmin. The directory should have the readable, writable, accessible permission. Not for any other user, only the sysadmin members, and also for the root user. And read this particular line. This is the SGID bit. It can be applied by using only the SGID bit. Read this line. Only this line. Have you read? Hello. Hello, Andre. Have you read this or not? Okay. Files created in this particular directory.
So what
is the effect? Automatically have the group ownership set to sysadmin group that I have told you. When we create any particular files in this directory, the group ownership will be this. So this is the owner, group owner. When we create any file, any folder in this particular location, the group ownership will be this. So this will be performed by the SGID bit. So like these questions, these comes in the exam. So when we create the, how I can change group ownership, how I can apply the permissions, and how I can apply the SGID bit, SUID bit, sticky bit. So like this, the questions come in the exam. Okay. So this, in this chapter, there are two questions come in the exam. Two questions come in RedHat exam. Like this. We create a group. The group user is this, like this. So these are the questions. So please do practice so you can perform these types of questions. Okay. So this is the effect of this command. So last, this is my last one command. I will demonstrate you. This is my SUID bit. This is the special permission. Last. So what is SUID means? Super user identification. There is no effect on the folder. I can't apply this on a folder. This will be applied only the executable files. This will be applied on the executable files. It means when we run any file as a command, so we can apply this. So I will demonstrate you by on the command. This I will show you this example by using the command. Suppose I have an example. So this is a command. What is the use of this command? This command is used to display the hard disk information. Related to the hard disk information, in the hard disk, how many partitions we have. How many partitions we have, it will display the information about the partitions. So we use hyphen L. L means list. So it will display the information at this time. Now you can check. This user can display the result of this particular command, but this command not performed by the standard user, but at this time standard user will perform, because we have changed this in any other class also. So we have a command which is used to check the location of this particular file. This is the location of this particular file. So I will check what is the permission of this particular file. Now you can check. It has a SUID bit assigned. by default it not assigned. We have changed this. So first we remove this particular, then I will show you. Chmod u minus s. Now you can check. At this time we have no suid, we have no suid, sgid, sticky bit on this particular file. So now you can check this command I have run. At this time this is not run by this particular user. Any user, any standard user can't run this particular command because it's a administrative command. It is performed by only the root user, not for regular accounts, not for non privileged accounts. So this is the command. We can't perform this. We can't run this because we have no permission. Because of the permission issue, we can't run this. But the admin want any user can run this command. Any user can run this command by the ownership of the root account. By the ownership of root account. What? Because at this time, this particular file, this particular command has the ownership of which? Root ownership. Only root can run this particular command, not the other user like this, any other user can't run this particular file. But this admin want any other user can run this file. What I will do? We can't change. When we change the user ownership of this particular user, then this particular user can perform, but not this user. So we want any user can run this particular command as a root ownership. I want to perform this command by root ownership. But at this time, we have no ownership rights. At this time, we have no ownership rights. But we won't run. Then what I will do? I can apply the SUID bit. So this permission will run this command as the ownership of root. So root can perform this command. So this is the special permission that is applied on the files that are to be executed by another user that have not ownership of that file, because this user not have the ownership of this, also user not have the ownership of this particular, only the root have the ownership, but we can't change the ownership and we want any other user can run this file, so we can apply this particular command. So now we have applied this. So now you can check any other user will perform this command. So it will display the information about the partition. We have this partition. In this partition, we have installed OS. This user also will perform this command. So any other user, the user has the ownership or not, can perform this command. So this special permission, this permission is used to execute as the user that own the file, not the user that run the file. Okay, the user that run the file not have the ownership, but at the time when the user run, it will take the ownership of that particular user account. So there is no effect on the folder. It's not applied on the folder, only for the files. So this permission only applied for the files, not for the directories. So this is the use of this particular SUID bit. So this is the special permission. Have you any doubt? Then I will resolve. If you have any doubt, so please tell me. Okay, hello. Have you any doubt or not?
No,
that's coming from a rich country. Okay, okay.
So this is these are the
from a rich country. I mean, a examples rich family, that I will, can give you money, but you don't so have these, to take the case.
These are the examples. So I will demonstrate you. These are the examples. Then the last topic is my default permission. This is my default permission. This is the last topic of this chapter. So I will demonstrate you within a 10 to 15 minutes. Okay. Then I will, on the next class, I will start the new chapter. Okay. So what is default permission? I will show you. Suppose. We have a file. When we create any file in any location, every user has some default permissions, some initial permissions like this. We create a file in /root. In this root goes to download. In download, we create a file, file 01. When we create any file in any location, it will have some initial rights. It has default rights. So what is the right of this particular file? This is the right. These are the initial permissions. These are the default permission. When any user, it can be a root, it can be a standard user, any user create the file and folders at the same time. Suppose this is my directory and I want to create this particular directory and I want to change the directory permission also. So now you can check what is the initial permission. These are called the initial permission. These are called the default permission. So these default permission will be replicated by the umask value. So these are default permissions. So these permissions replicated by the umask value. At this time, what is the umask value of this particular account? This is the umask that change the default permission. When we change this, this permission will automatically change for files and folders. At this time, root. This is my root account. When we create a file, what is my initial permission? Initial permission. So for file, we have read, write, read and read. So this is R means 4 2 6 4 4. So it's a 6 4 4. And for directory, what is the initial permission? This is the initial permission. This is 7 5 5. So this is 7 5 5. So these are called default permission. The default permission will be affected by the umask value. So umask value change these permissions. Suppose at this time we have the umask value of this. So how it can affect on a file and folders? So every file and folders have the permission of read, write and execute. So it's called 7. So we want to check this. Full permission is 777 and for files full permission can be 666. It's for directory and it's for files. When we minus this permission, when we minus this by the umask value 022, when we minus this from the umask value, so what is the permission? Rest permission. So it's called 7 5. When we minus this from the UMAS value, so this is the initial permission. So every folders will access this permission. When we minus this from, it's for the files. When we minus this, the UMAS value from the UMAS value. So this is my UMAS value. Then minus this. It means subtract this, not add. So we can 644. So this is the initial permission. So this is affected by this particular value. When we change this value, this permission will be changed. This permission will be changed. So it's for the files and it's for the folders. So this is the effect of default permission, that is replicated by the UMAS value. So I will show you what is default permission. When you create a new file and directory, it assigns the initial permission. The first is whether you creating a regular file. When you create a file, it has different permission. When you create a directory, it's a different permission. So for file, file has different permission and folders also have the different permission. This is affected by the current UMAS value. This is replicated by the UMAS value. When you change the UMAS value, your permission for the files and folders will be changed. Create a new directory. So your operating system starts by assigning its octal permission. So this is the octal value, by which it will be minus the UMAS value, subtract the UMAS value. So for the files, from this, we can minus this from this particular value. So UMAS value is used, UMAS is used to change, to assign the initial permission. So when we have the UMAS value of this, so your initial permissions will be affected by this. When you have this particular, your files and folders will be affected by this. So we can use this. So these are the directory where the UMAS value is assigned by default. This is the directory, /etc/basrc. In this, we can change the UMAS value also. And this is the current from which we can also change the UMAS value. In this location, we can change the UMAS value. So we can change, if we want to change, we can change by these particular files. So how I can change this? So I will demonstrate you. So when we change the UMAS value, we change 222. What is the effect of this particular? When we create any file, suppose /yyy, this is my file, sorry, directory, and we want to check yyy. So now you can check, this is the initial permission. And I will change this again. So what is the effect again? We change yycc, create a directory. This is the directory name. Then I want to check. So now you can check. I can't change the permission. We only change the UMAS value. So this UMAS value will affect the initial permission. It will be synchronized by this particular. When we change this, so this will find this particular initial permission. This is called initial permission, default permission. By default, it will find, it will gain these permissions. When we change this, so what it will find? It will find a full permission on user, on group. So this is default permission. This is the initial permission that will be affected by the UMAS value. This is the temporary command, and we want to change this permanently. So what I will do, we can use this particular configuration file. It's a bash rc. In this we can change the UMAS value. When we change the UMAS value, your default permission will be changed automatically. So what is the default UMask? This is the default UMask. So this is the default UMask. When we check this for the user, so for the standard user it is this, and for the root account, for the root account, what is this? It's also changed. So now you can check, this is for the regular root account, this is for the root account, and this is for the regular account. So you now you can check, this is for which? This is for the regular account, and this for the root account, because root have the ID 0. So what it will, this is a script, this is a scripting. If we start a condition from if that is closed by the fi, it's a reverse. So this is the scripting. When we have the SUID greater than 199, the UMAS value will be this. When we have the greater than of this, then UMAS bill will be this. So if any user has the else, it means else. Else means the root account has the SUID 0. So it will gain this, and the other user gain this. So any regular account will gain this particular UMAS value, and the root will gain this particular value. So the initial permission will be affected by this for the root account, and for the regular account this is affected by the this particular UMAS value. So this is the effect of the UMAS value. You can change by from this location, and we can also change from the current directory. It's in a current directory, it's a bash rc file. We can also apply here. So when we type here umask, then 222, this is only for this particular user, not for other user. When we change this in this particular file .bashrc, it's a hidden file. So this is affected by only this user. When we change for this, this is affected by this user only, not for this. For individual user, we can use this particular configuration file. For all user, we can use this particular file. It has, this is the global configuration file. So we can change from this location, and we can also change from the current location of my current working directory, from my current working directory. So this is the effect. Then I will quit this, not change. So these are two files from which we can change, and also have the another files like this. We can change by the etc profile, from the etc profile, and we can also change .bash_profile. These are the files. This is also a file. This is in a home directory, and this is the global file. So we can change the UMAS value. When we change the UMAS value, your initial permission will be changed automatically. Okay, so have you any doubt in this? Hello, Andre, have you any doubt regarding?
No, sir, it's fine.
Okay, no, okay. So this is my last topic that I will some example also here. Now we will discuss next class, the chapter, new chapter. So I have completed 7 chapters. So next chapter will be in a next class. If you have any doubt, you can ask. So this chapter will be complete, and I will start your next topic from this particular chapter. This is my networking classes. So I will start this later, 8, 9, 10. I will start this from this particular chapter. So this is my networking chapter that I will start your networking classes. So how I can assign the IP, how can check the connectivity to another PC. So your networking will be start of Linux in a Linux OS. How I can use these commands. So these are the commands that used in a Linux. So these are the commands. Networking concept. So this is the command NMCLI. This is command that I will discuss in earlier class. Next class, not earlier. So these are the, when we create, how to create the connections. So these are the commands. It have a long commands. This is a big command that I used to create the connection. So how I can give the IP, how can assign the gateway IP, and how I can check this. So these are the commands to create a connection, to assign the IP, to give the DNS IP. So I will use this in next class. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, ji.
Yes.
So I will end the session, and I will send you this video and data also.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Okay. Welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you for that.